open letter to Marvel Comics. I've always been confused about your flagship character, Captain America. As the most militarized nation in the history of the world, I don't understand how our mascot's primary weapon is a shield. I feel like he'd be more authentic if he walked with a nuclear missile stuffed into his tidy whities, or if he stalked around waterboarding terrorists with Diet Coke, or if he toted a bag of Big Macs to clog the arteries of his enemies. If the next Avengers movie is a prequel, and we travel back to 1492, would they call Christopher Columbus Captain America? Would his weapon be a flag infected with smallpox, or if it was set in Hawaii 1778? Would that American captain's name be Cook, his weapon a ship full of cholera? When I see that shield, I am reminded that 1 in 8 adult natives in Guam is a U.S. veteran. That American Samoa has the top army recruiting station in the country, that Polynesian islanders have the highest casualty rates in our armed forces. We are dying to belong. And I'm beginning to understand the metaphor of Captain America's weapon. So show me how a country builds a human shield, fills a military with the children of nations it has slain. We in the United States spend over 8 times as much on warfare than we do on education, than we wait. As failing schools spit out kids unserved, wait until the opportunities we dreamed of seem farther away than the stars our people once used as maps. Then we ask the question to the young: would you fire a gun to feed your sons? Would you die on a battlefield to build a house for your daughter? We in America, our news outlets decry warlords in Africa for enlisting 13-year-old soldiers, while every week I watch ROTC recruiters fish my cousins out of classroom C. When the military grabs the land your family used to farm, sugar plantation becomes platoon. But when farmers till the earth with guns, the only crop is blood. When war is our only industry, the only crop is blood. In these territories, American Samoa, Guam, Puerto Rico, Northern and Marianas Virgin Islands, the people have no vote to cast for the US president who decides where and when we go to war. So they are a shield with a lip, but no mouth, no say what country it will be thrown into next. We are so much more than war's bone and blood fist, more than body made bullet trap. I will show you how a shield given no voice can still grow teeth, still teach itself how to speak. We, survivors turned soldiers, we once and always will be warriors. We ask Captain America, when your shield, our people, decide our lives are worth more than the price of your citizenship, what will you hide behind then? Yeah!